sending him for grammar classes. You know, his grammar is very weak. Hai. Ma'am, he needs to pay attention to grammar. He does not understand tenses. Hello, and welcome to Musings of a Masterling. Heard these statements? I'm sure you have. But here I am, Meenal Desai, and I welcome you to Musings of a Masterling, where I share a medley of my unique experiences, shaped by students, teachers, and life in general. So, recently I came across this parent who was talking to a teacher, and the parent was concerned that, you know, his grammar is not in place, and grammar is supposedly the base of any language. I was very intrigued by it, because I wonder, is grammar really the base of everything, of a language? Look back at your mother tongue. Whatever your mother tongue is, did you learn its grammar first? I was Gujarati. I don't think any child ever learns a language of, at least the mother tongue, in terms of grammar first and then the language. It just doesn't come that way, right? A language is learned first by listening to it for years together. Then kind of starting to speak in broken sentences, in simple words and all that. And then writing and reading and all that. But somehow we schools, we tend to do it like completely ulta. We start with the writing first and then expect the child to like language and all that. But that apart, coming back to the grammar part of it. What does grammar do today and why are we so obsessed with it? You know, there was a time when grammar used to form about 25-30% of the paper. And there were actually board marks and board papers where you had to answer, change the tense to this, do as directed, all that. But I really request all of you to please look at the papers today. If you are in an international board, I'm sure you've realized that grammar per se like that is not asked, do as directed wala format. But please check grammar in terms of CBSE papers as well. Even the boards have realized that we need to move beyond that. Language is the use of words to express yourself, to communicate. Grammar is just a means to that. Even the CBSE paper hardly has some 30% for grammar and writing, which includes writing, and actual grammar, what you can say, is hardly 5 or 8 marks, which also is something that the child would be able to understand very clearly if the child has taken the pains of really reading enough. Grammar is a structure that helps the language, but the child cannot learn the language through the means of grammar. For any language to be acquired, there has to be an ecosystem that's there. And fluency has to come before perfection. Grammar gives you perfection. Ki, haan, ye tense mein aise bolna hai, etc., etc. But you cannot acquire a language like that. Language is not maths. First, you have to acquire fluency. Sacha, jhootha, sach, galat, whatever. You kind of start blabbering in those words. And when you do that, that is when slowly, steadily you understand the nuances of grammar. And if you choose to write in that language as an author, writer, or if you have to communicate formally in that language, you need to understand the grammar of that language. But otherwise, honestly speaking, grammar is not the base of any language. So then, what do we as parents, teachers, what do? Do we not focus on grammar? Do we not look at it? I don't say we don't look at it, but I think reading storybooks and immersing yourself in that language is a far more rewarding experience than trying to find the subordinate and the main clause and trying to change the tense from one thing to another. Do we schools still do that? Yes, we do. We are great dinosaurs who refuse to believe that things have moved on. But that said, we also realize that our children need to write better using grammar. So let us look at grammar as a means to an end rather than an end itself. My dear viewers, can you tell me what has been your experience with grammar? What kind of books did you use? Were you a part of the Ren and Martin genre where, you know, you were expected to write everything in that sense? Or did grammar come naturally to you? How was your schooling and what is your take on grammar? Would love to know more about this. And lastly, don't forget to subscribe to Musings of a Masterling on Instagram and YouTube. Thank you so much.